Yeah, actually today I came in Prabhupada house. I said, let's do the class from Prabhupada house.
Yeah, I said not to start that yet because it's a closed room and it's still an environment that will spread the coronavirus if people come in.
Yeah, no, I just came for darshan today. So I thought, let me give the class. So for the online people there, they can have darshan of Srila Prabhupada.
Jai Sri Prabhupada. Yeah, I haven't been for darshan myself either.
Okay. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. So for the viewers, this is Srila Prabhupada's house in Vrindavan. The house where Srila Prabhupada stayed for many days, and also in his final days, Srila Prabhupada was staying in the same house, the same bed. Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada. Okay, so we'll just start in 1 minute. I'll just sit and we'll start.
Yes, Prabhupada.
Okay, Hare Krishna. So welcome all the devotees. So we'll have a short kirtan. And my sound is clear?
Yeah, that's fine, Prabhu. Carry on.
Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Gopi Jana Vallabha Girivara Dhari Jaya Gopi Jana Vallabha Girivara Dhari Yashoda Nandana Prajjana Rajjana Yashoda Nandana Prajjana Rajjana Yamuna Tira Vanachari Yamuna Tira Vanachari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Kadatha Shivasati Govinda Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Shri Vasadi Go Dutta Vinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Jai Gaura Nitai, Gaura Nitai, Gaura Nitai, Shri Shri Gaura Nitai, Gaura Nitai, Gaura Nitai, Gaura Nitai, Shri Shri Gaura Nitai, Krishna Balaram, Krishna Balaram, Krishna Balaram, Jaya Krishna Balaram, Krishna Balaram, Krishna Balaram, Krishna Balaram, Jaya Krishna Balaram, Jaya Radha Shama Sundar, Radha Shama Sundar Radhe, Radha Shama Sundar, Radha Shama Sundar Radhe, Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, Nitai Gaur Hari Gaur, Hari Gaur, Hari Gaur, Nitai Gaur Hari Gaur, Nitai Gaur Hari Gaur, Hari Gaur, Hari Gaur, Nitai Gaur Hari Gaur, Shri Shri Harinam Sankirtan Ki Jai, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai, Nitai Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Gaur. Hare Krishna. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Mataji, should I share the screen?
I can share the screen if you want me to.
Okay.
Do you want me to share the verse or do you want more to share?
Yeah, so I'll let me share, because first I'll share the verse and then I want to share something else also.
Okay, let me just allow it.
Yeah.
Okay, Prabhu.
Yeah, thank you. So today we are reading a very important verse from 15th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. As you all know that this is a special month of Purushottam, where specifically it is said that one should chant the 15th verse of Bhagavad Gita, because the name of the 15th chapter is Yoga of the Supreme Person or Purushottam Yoga. And today we are going to recite a very, very important verse, the 6th verse of the 15th chapter. I'm very grateful to her, this loving Latidra Mataji, for giving me this opportunity. This is a very, very famous verse. I'm sure many of you must have heard it before. So let us chant this important verse.
Natadhashate Suryo Nashashanko Napavakaha
यद् कत्वा न निवर्तन्ते तथाम परमं मम न तद्भाषते सूर्यो नास शांको न पावकः यद् कत्वा न निवर्तन्ते तथाम परमं मम न तद्भाषते सूर्यो न शशांको न पावकः यद् गत्वा न निवर्तन्ते तद्धाम परमं मम रिपीट द वर्ड बाय वर्ड न नॉट तत् दैट भाषेते इल्यूमिनेट्स सूर्यः द सन न नॉर शशांकः द मून न नॉर पावकः फायर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी यत् Where, gatva, going, na, never, nivartante, they come back, tadhama, that abode, paramam, supreme, mama, mine. That supreme abode of mine is not illumined by the sun or moon, nor by fire or electricity. Those who reach it never return to this material world. Once again, let me repeat the translation. That supreme abode of mine is not illumined by the sun or moon, nor by fire or electricity. Those who reach it never return to this material world. Purport by His Divine Grace, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. The spiritual world, the abode of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, which is known as Krishna Loka, Goloka Vrindavan is described here. The spiritual sky, there is no need of sunshine, moonshine, fire or electricity because all the planets are self-luminous. We have only one planet in this universe, the sun, which is self-luminous. But all the planets in the spiritual sky are self-luminous. The shining effulgence of all those planets called Vaikunthas constitutes the shining sky known as the Brahma Jyoti. Actually, the effulgence is emanating from the planet of Krishna, Goloka Vrindavan. Part of that shining effulgence is covered by Mahat Tattva, the material world. Other than this, the major portion of that shining sky is full of spiritual planets, which is called Vaikunthas, chief of which is Goloka Vrindavan. As long as a living entity is in this dark material world, he is in conditional life. But as soon as he reaches the spiritual sky, by cutting through the false, perverted tree of this material world, he becomes liberated. Then there is no chance of his coming back here. In his conditional life, the living entity considers himself to be the lord of this material world. But in his liberated state, he enters into the spiritual kingdom and becomes an associate of the Supreme Lord. There he enjoys eternal bliss, eternal life, and full knowledge. Now, this is such a beautiful line by Srila Prabhupada. Please pay attention. One should be captivated by this information. He should desire to transfer himself to that eternal world and extricate himself from this false reflection of reality. For one who is too much attached to this material world, it is very difficult to cut that attachment. But if he takes to Krishna consciousness, there is a chance of gradually becoming detached. One has to associate himself with devotees, those who are in Krishna consciousness. One should search out a society dedicated to Krishna consciousness and learn how to discharge devotional service. In this way, he can cut off his attachment to the material world. One cannot become detached from the attraction of the material world simply by dressing himself in saffron cloth. He must become attached to the devotional service of the Lord. Therefore, one should take it very seriously that devotional service, as described in the 12th chapter, is the only way to get out of this false representation of the real tree. In the chapter 14, the contaminations of all kinds of processes by material nature is described. Only devotional service is purely transcendental. The words parama mama are very important here. Actually, every nook and corner is a property of the Supreme Lord, but the spiritual world is paramam, full of six opulences. The Katha Upanishad also confirms that in the spiritual world there is no need of sunshine, moonshine, or stars. Na tatra surya, whole spiritual sky is illuminated by the internal potency. That supreme abode can be achieved only by surrender and by no other means. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Shakshurmlitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manovishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Karamiyam Dadati Swaprantikam Undeham Shri Guru Shri Uta Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamsha श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधा कृष्णपादां सहगण ललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये वंशकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुवेव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्ण पृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी विचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणी जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा सो वेलकम यू ऑल अगेन फॉर टुडेज वंडरफुल श्लोका टुडेज क्लास बेस्ड अपॉन अ वेरी फेमस वर्ड्स ऑन भगवद गीता न तत् भाषते सूर्यो न शशांक न पावक यद् गत्वा न निवर्तन्ते तद् धाम परमम् सो कृष्णा इज गिविंग हियर द सीक्रेट दैट देयर इज अ सुप्रीम प्लैनेट ऑफ हिज सुप्रीम अबोर्ड ऑफ हिज व्हिच इज हिज परमम धामम एंड दैट वर्ल्ड इज सेल्फ इफल्जेंट देयर इज नो नीड ऑफ लाइट एक्सटर्नल लाइट लाइक सन मून एक्सेट्रा This world is a place of darkness. If there is no sun, there is no moon, there is no electricity, then everything is pitch dark. Therefore, the Vedas say, Tamasi Ma Jyotirgama, that give up this world of darkness and go to the world of light. Many times people, they don't accept that there is a spiritual world. But Krishna has very clearly mentioned here, that I have a supreme abode of mine. Srila Prabhupada explains that yes, everything belongs to God. Even in this material world is also Krishna's kingdom. No doubt about it. But this is not the supreme kingdom. This is not a supreme planet. This is like a jail. But the actual, Krishna's real home is Goloka Vrindavan. You know, just like a rich businessman, he may have so many properties. He may have a property in different countries. Maybe, let's say, Mr. Ambani. You know, he may have a property in London, in America, in all the major cities of India. But still, he has his own home in Mumbai, where he stays with his family. That is his real home. Yes, everything belongs to him. He has so many properties. But his home is his most dear place. Similarly, the entire existence belongs to Krishna. Like Krishna has told in Bhagavad Gita, Bhukta Ram Yagyatapasam, Sarva Loka Maheshwaram, Surudam Sarva Bhutanam, Yantva Mam Shanti Vichati. Everything belongs to the Lord. But his own home is Golok Vrindavan. That is where he stays. Like Srila Prabhupada says that we know the name of God, we know his father's name, that is Nanda Maharaj or Vasudev, we know his mother's name, Yashoda, Devaki, and we know his address. His address is Goloka Vrindavan. So this is such a nice information Krishna is giving, that my dhama, my abode, is such a wonderful place. If you come here, you don't have to return back to this material world. Because in this material world, there is no permanent place. Krishna says, Abrahma Bhuvana Loka Punar Avartina Arjuna Mam Upatyatu Punar Janma. So in this world, you go from the topmost planet, Brahma. Abrahma Bhuvana Loka Punar Avartina Arjuna. Wherever you go, you have to come back again to this material world. Even if you go to the heavenly planets, Shina Punye, Marte Loka Vishanti. So, even if you go to the heavenly planets, once our pious deeds are over, we have to come back to this earthly planet. But if you go to the spiritual world, there is no question of coming back. Therefore, Srila Prabhupada, he started a magazine called Back to Godhead. Because he wants all of us to go back home, back to Godhead. Because Krishna himself wants that. He desires us, all of us, we should come back to his home. And his home is unlimited. One may think, oh, if all the living entities, they go to Golok Vrindavan, there'll be overcrowd there, there'll be lack of accommodation. No, it's unlimited. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is mentioned that even one Vaikuntha planet is unlimited in size. It's like trillions of miles. It's like inconceivable. So what to speak of Golok Vrindavan, which is the topmost planet. It is infinite. So there is no scarcity of land there. Everyone can stay there. In fact, we all have our eternal home there. We all have our eternal relationship with Krishna. We all have an eternal form in the spiritual world, which is our Swarupa. We all have an eternal relationship with the Lord. We have eternal service there. We have our home ready there. We have our dress ready there. Everything is ready for us. But we are so foolish, all the conditioned fools, that we want to enjoy in this world separate from the Lord. So stupid we are. We have all facilities in the spiritual world, but we want to stay in this material world. Why? Because we want to enjoy separate from the Lord. This attitude of enjoying separate from the Lord, Aham Bhogi, Ishwar Aham, Aham Bhogi. That I am the controller, I am the enjoyer. Because of these two desires we have in this material world. We want to enjoy and we want to control. But Krishna is so merciful and kind. He is giving us this information. Oh my dear sons, we are all Krishna's part and parcel. Why are you suffering this horrible material world? With his birth, death, old age, disease, there's so many problems. Now we are all going through this COVID problem. God knows how many more such problems will come in this Kali Yuga as time progresses. So we should take this information very seriously. Therefore, Srila Prabhupada writes such an important line here. I remember many, many years back when I read this purport, this line struck me so much. One should be captivated by this information. If you see in the third paragraph, we read this line, one should be captivated by this information. He should desire to transfer himself to that eternal world and extricate himself from this false reflection of reality. In the first four verses of this chapter, Krishna is explaining how this material world is a false reflection of the spiritual world. It's a perverted reflection of the spiritual world. In this material world, the branches are down and the roots are up. It's like a topsy-turvy, you know. upside down. A very crazy world, this material world. So this is a reflection of the actual world. So therefore, since this world also has varieties, that world also has varieties. The impersonalists or the Mayavadis, they think that spiritual world means just Brahman, just light. You just go and merge there. But no. If this world has so much variety, and this world is a perverted reflection of the actual world, don't you think the real world should have variety? Like suppose I look at my reflection in the mirror. So if my reflection has a tilak, obviously I have a tilak, therefore the reflection is having a tilak. I am wearing specs, therefore reflection is wearing, having specs. Similarly, in this material world, we have trees, we have animals, we have plants, we have lakes. So obviously in the spiritual world also, all these varieties are there. But that is in the pure form. And in this world, it is all contaminated. That's the difference. In that world, the center is Krishna. Everyone wants to serve Krishna. In this world, the center is me. Everyone wants to serve himself, not Krishna. That's the difference. There, everyone wants to satisfy Krishna's senses, which is called love for Krishna. And here, everyone wants to satisfy his own senses, which is called lust. Krishna Indriya Priti Vancha, Tare Bole Prema, Atma Indriya Priti Vancha, Hare Kamna. Chetan Chetam, it says that when you want to satisfy our own senses, that is called lust. And when we want to satisfy Krishna's senses, that is called love for Krishna. So in the spiritual world, everybody has love for Krishna. And that is why that world is so beautiful. And honey, zoom pe de raha. So this information should be so attractive for all of us. But unfortunately, most people are not interested in this. See, there are three categories of people. Some, they don't even know about this spiritual world. They are so unfortunate, right? And there are some who know about the spiritual world, but still they are not so interested to go there. But the most fortunate people are those who have heard about the spiritual world and they have made a firm determination in their life that in this life, I will perform very serious devotional service and aim of my life is to go home back to God. So in which category you want to be? Of course, we are not in the third category. Today you already got information about the spiritual world. So either we are in the second category or first. Majority of us, like me, I'm in the second category. I've heard about the spiritual world, but still I don't have a strong desire to go there. I'm still interested in enjoying this world. Like suppose today, a Vimana from Vaikuntha comes and tells that, let's go. Will you be ready? Will I be ready? I doubt. I will say, oh, Prabhuji, I have so many work to do. I'll not be ready. We are not ready to go there. This is a nice story. There was a nice saint called Tukaram in Maharashtra. Very famous saint. Very great devotee of the Lord. Devotee of Panduranga. And he had a very funny wife. His wife was very unfavorable in his devotional service. She always used to nag him and, you know, make fun of him and always, you know, trouble him. Oh, why are you doing so much bhakti? What are you getting? You're not earning money to maintain the family nicely. But anyway, Tukaram didn't care. He was always absorbed. Panduranga, Panduranga, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. So he was a great devotee. Rama Krishna Hari. And in the end, when the time came, a Vaikuntha, a Vimana, special plane from the spiritual world came to take him. And he was ready to go there. And remembered his wife. He called his wife, come on, you also join me. Let's go to Krishna's planet. And you know what his wife said? No, 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 I can't go. Who will take care of my buffaloes? So imagine, she got an opportunity to go to the spiritual world and she was worried about her buffaloes. That's our condition. You should not laugh. That is at least my condition. We are so much attached to these petty things in this world that if right now Krishna says, come back to my spiritual world, I'm not ready for it. So let's prepare ourselves. The first step in doing that is we should hear the glories of the spiritual Guru. Because the more we hear about Lord, his wonderful pastimes, then our desire to go there will become strong. And our attachment to this world will become less and less. So from where do we get information of the spiritual world? Bhagavad Gita talks in very brief. Like this verse says, there is no, that world is self-effulgent. There is no sun, there is no moon, etc. One who goes there never comes back. But what is, how does the world look like? What people do there? So these are some of the questions that should come in our mind. And fortunately, all these answers have been given in Srimad Bhagavatam. So Srimad Bhagavatam is like expanded Bhagavad Gita. Right? So in Srimad Bhagavatam, I'd like to share with you. Let me just try and open it. In the 15th chapter of 3rd canto, this very nice description of spiritual world. Okay, so let me open that for you. The chapter name is Description of the Kingdom of God. Such an amazing chapter, you know. Describes how the spiritual world looks like. So the context is that the four Kumaras, they went to the spiritual world. So the description of the spiritual world is given. Okay, let's read a few verses from here. Srimad Bhagavatam, 3rd canto, 15th chapter, verse number 13. They also entered into the spiritual sky, for they were afraid, they were freed from all material contamination. In the spiritual sky, the spiritual planets known as Vaikunthas, which are the residence of the Supreme Personality of Godhead and His pure devotees, and are worshipped by the residents of all material planets. In the Vaikuntha planets, all the residents are similar in form to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. They all engage in devotional service to the Lord without desires for sense gratification. This is a very, very important point, that they all engage in devotional service to the Lord without any desire for sense gratification. The Vaikuntha planets is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is the original person and who can be understood through the Vedic literature, is full of uncontaminated mode of goodness with no place for passion or ignorance. He contributes religious progress for the devotees. In those Vaikuntha planets, there are many forests which are very auspicious. In those forests, the trees are desired trees, and in all seasons, they are filled with flowers and fruits, because everything in the Vaikuntha planets is spiritual and personal. Such important point. The beautiful forest in the Vaikuntha planets, the beautiful trees, and they're called desire trees, because they can fulfill desires of everyone. They're called Vansha Kalpa, Kalpataru. And they're filled with so many beautiful flowers and fruits, and everything is a person in the spiritual world. Amazing. In the Vaikuntha planets, the inhabitants fly in their airplanes, accompanied by their wives and consorts, and eternally sing of the character and activities of the Lord, which are always devoid of all inauspicious qualities. While singing the glories of the Lord, they deride even the presence of the blossoming Madhavi flowers, which are fragrant and laden with honey. So this is the important point, that what do devotees do in the spiritual world? They all glorify the beautiful pastimes of the Lord. They sing of His wonderful activities, that is Kirtan, right? When the king of bees hums in a high pitch, singing the glories of the Lord, there's a temporary lull in the noise of the pigeon, the cuckoo, the crane, the charavaka, the swan, the parrot, the patrician, and the peacock. Such transcendental birds stop their own singing simply to hear the glories of the Lord. Just see the spiritual world. In this world, we all want to sing. We think that I have such a sweet voice. But there, it's opposite. Even birds like cuckoo, who have very sweet voice, they stop singing when bumblebee starts singing. Usually, bumblebee sound is not so good. Some kind of hissing sound it makes. But all the other birds, they stop their singing because they want to hear the glories of the Lord as chanted by the bumblebee. Such a beautiful world. In this world is reverse. I want to glorify and I don't want to listen anyone else. No, there is opposite. When other devotees glorify the Lord, they all want to hear from them. Yeah, there was a little problem in internet. I'm back now. So we were discussing a beautiful verse from Srimad Bhagavatam, the glories of the spiritual world, where it was said that how the Tulasi is so much respected by all the other flowers. Although in the spiritual world, there are beautiful flowers like Kunda, Maliti, and Parijata, and so many wonderful flowers. But everyone, they respect Tulasi. Why? Because Tulasi is very dear to the Lord. And Srila Prabhupada, that's a beautiful line. I'll just read this line for you. So he said they all special for the Lord who garlands himself with tulsi leaves. Srila Prabhupada says the importance of tulsi leaves is very clearly mentioned here. Tulsi plants and the leaves are very important in devotional service. Devotees are recommended to water the tulsi tree Hare Krishna. I'm sorry, I don't know the signal is. Anyway, so I'll just conclude the class in 5 minutes. So, Srila Prabhupada says the most important quality in the spiritual world is that devotees, they don't have any envy for Krishna, envy for each other. Usually in this world, we all envious of each other. But in the spiritual world, there is no envy. And in another verse, the next verse in this section, it is said that although the devotee is there, they have the nice concerts, vibes, but they're not attracted by sex enjoyment. So the spiritual world is freed from all kinds of lusty desires, all kinds of envy. So those who have lust and envy, they can't have this spiritual world. Therefore, Krishna says in 15.5, Nirmana moha jita sanga dosha adhyatma nitya vinibhitya kama vande di mukte sukha dukha samne. Krishna is saying the qualification to go to the spiritual world is nirmana moha chitta sanga dosha adhyatma nitya vinditya kama. You should be freed from all lusty desires. You should be freed from desire to get a lot of respect, name and fame in this world. You should be freed from all those qualities, from the association of the three moods. And only when he's pure, then he can go. And what do devotees do there? It's mentioned the goddess of fortune. All the spiritual world is so wonderful. Chinta, mani, prakara, sattva, shukalpa, viksha, laksha, vritesha, shurabhira, vipala, yantam. Lakshmi sahasrita sambhrama sevyamanam adi purusham tamam bhajami. So Brahma Chintamani gems. There's no ordinary stones there, everything Chintamani gems. And the trees there are all kalpavrikshas. The cows there are all Surabhi cows. And there are millions of goddesses of fortune must engage in the service of Lord Narayan or Krishna there. So what do the Lakshmis do there? They clean the temple, floor of the temple of the Lord. Although there is no dirt there, but still they clean it with their own saris. Why? They want to please the Lord. See, everybody is busy in the spiritual world, neither singing the glories of the Lord or doing some service for the Lord. So it's not a world of inactivity or we just merge into the Brahman and just sit and meditate. No. Spiritual world is a dynamic world, that everybody is engaged in Krishna's service. Some of the devotees, they serve Krishna by singing of his wonderful qualities, his name, his form, his pastimes. And some of the devotees, they serve the Lord by making beautiful garlands for them. What do the gopis do in Golok Vrindavan? Some of them, they make beautiful garlands for the Lord. Some of them, they clean the Lord's temple. The gopis, they make nice butter for Krishna. Radharani and the gopis, they cook nice food stuff for Krishna. So everybody is so busy in serving Krishna. That's the spiritual world. It's not a world of inactivity. Everybody is busy, neither singing the glories of the Lord or serving the Lord. And therefore, they are not interested in anything else. They have no lust. They have no envy. They have no material desires. Their only desire is to please Krishna. So therefore, if we want to go there, so this is the second part of my small talk today. So first part I said that we should hear about the spiritual world more and more. Then we'll develop a desire to go there. And what is the qualification to go there? We must be freed from all the material contamination. And that can be possible when we practice devotional service. So the activity is the same. It's not that there we have some new mantra. No. Here also we have Hare Krishna mantra. There also we have Hare Krishna. One Srila Prabhupada, somebody asked Srila Prabhupada, what is the aim of chanting Hare Krishna? Prabhupada said to chant Hare Krishna. That means we are chanting here. It's not that one day when we are perfect, we'll give up our feedback and we'll chant some other mantra. No. We always chant the Maha Mantra. Now we are chanting in this world. We are not pure, but we are chanting holy names. And gradually when we become purified, we'll also continue chanting holy names. But that will be Shudhanam, that will be pure holy names of the Lord. And the spiritual world also will chant the holy name. Therefore, the song is Golo Kera Prema Dhana Hari Nama Sankirtan. This Hari Nama Sankirtan is actually the wealth of the Golok Vrindavan. When the gopis, they chant this Mahamantra. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is Krishna himself in the form of Srimati Radharani, has brought this Mahamantra to all of us. Shri Radhara Bhavede Goravatar Hare Krishna Nam Gura Jaya Jagannandana Tripuvane Kore Charada Charana. So we should remember this, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come here to give us this Golokira Prema Dhana Harinama Sankirtan, the highest wealth of Golok Vrindavan. He has come to give all of us, the most fallen people in this Kali Yuga. And we are so fortunate that the Guru Parampara, we have received this Maha Mantra. So we should be very, very serious and very eager to actually go back to the spiritual world. We must take to this Hare Krishna Maha Mantra with a lot of eagerness, a lot of seriousness. This should be our most important service, chanting Maha Mantra seriously, because this is what will purify us, and this is what will actually gradually lead to the rise of love of God. So actually, ultimately, we need Krishna prema to go there. This Krishna prema will gradually rise in our heart. Nitya Siddha Krishna prema sadhya kabanai, Shravan adi sudha chitte paralvis. The more Shravan and Kirtan we do, gradually this Krishna prema will rise in our heart. It's already there. It has to be uncovered. So the more we do hearing and chanting, hum jitna Shravan Kirtan karenge, the more Shravan and Kirtan we do, this love of Godhead will gradually arise in our heart. This Bhakti Lata creeper will grow and grow and grow. And one day we'll reach the lotus feet of Krishna. So this is what we should all aspire for. We should aspire to reach back to spiritual world. Dev Nandan Das has sung this beautiful song. Radha Krishna Prana Mora Jugala Kishor Jivane Marane Gati Arnahimo. He says, very beautiful song. Kalindira kule keli Tatana vidira upa He says in this song that when I make nice garden, so when that day will come, I will handle it to Radha Krishna. This is called lalas. That one day I will also go back to the spiritual world and serve Radha and Krishna. And how will I serve? Under the directions of the devotee, not directly. Lalita Vishakhadi Jata Sakhi Brinda Agnay Karibo Seva Charanar Vinda. Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Dasiranu Das Prarthana Karai Sada Narottam Das. Narottam Das Thakuri, please, when that day will come, when will I serve Radha and Krishna as a servant of the servant of Lord Chaitanya? So that should be aspiration. And of course, a devotee doesn't demand to Krishna. What Mahaprabhu has told us, na dhanam, na janam, na sundarim, kavitam va jagadishe kame, mama janmani janmanishvare, bhavata akti rahetu kirti. So prayer of devotees, oh Krishna, I don't want any wealth, I don't want beautiful women, I don't want any followers, I don't want name and fame in this world, I only want your causeless devotional service, life after life. That means he's not even praying for liberation. That means a devotee doesn't even pray to Krishna that take me to Goloka Vrindavan. No, he's happy simply serving Krishna. Krishna wants, he will take me to Krishna. Doesn't want, no problem. Because for a devotee, actually, there's no difference. Because here also we'll chant Hare Krishna. And there also we'll chant Hare Krishna. So there is no difference for a pure devotee, actually. For him, everything is special. But of course, we should be attracted by this information and we should develop a desire and then leave it to Krishna. It's up to Krishna. If he wants to take us back, no problem. If he wants us to know you stay here, no problem. So all we have to do is continue performing devotional service, and the main form of devotional service is chanting the Mahamantra, chanting the glories of the Lord. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. I want to thank all of you for attending this class. The beautiful verse, once again, I'll repeat the verse. Natat bhashyate suryo na sashanka na pavaka yad gatvana nivartante tat dhamam paramamuva. Krishna is saying, please come back to my spiritual world. Because once you come there, you don't have to come back to this material world. So, let us all be captivated by this information, like Shri Prabhupada says, and let us develop that desire to go. Any questions, any comments? We have 5 minutes left, 5-10 minutes. Any questions or comments? I'll be very happy if some people ask some questions.
Vaikunth had his hand up before.
Yes, sure.
You can ask.
Yes, those who want to ask question, you can unmute your Zoom. Yes.
Reji,
yeah, who is asking?
Reji Vaikunth.
Vaikunth. Yes,
Vaikunth. As a student, how can we manage materialistic studies and spirituality?
Okay, nice question. As students, how do we manage material studies and spirituality? Actually, for a devotee, nothing is material. What is material and spiritual? When we do anything for sense gratification, that is material. When we do something for Krishna, that is spiritual. You may be singing kirtan, but if our desire is that to see how nicely I am singing, then that becomes tainted with material desire. So, therefore, the best is that we, whatever we do it for the pleasure of Krishna. Then nothing is material. So, whatever studies you are doing, if you are doing it for the pleasure of Krishna, that is also spiritual. Okay, so for devotee, nothing is material. So, he does everything for the pleasure of Lord. Yat karoshi, yat asnasi, yat jhulsi, tadasi, yat tapasyasi kantya, tat purushottama darpanam. He does for the pleasure of the Lord. That means you want to say that Arjuna was a materialist. He was fighting in the battlefield. He was shooting arrows, but he was doing it for the pleasure of Krishna. So therefore, he's the best devotee. Therefore, when you do studies also, if you do in that mood that I'm doing it to please Krishna, then that is also devotional service. And you can always take guidance from your teacher how to balance your studies and your Krishna consciousness. Okay? Hare Krishna. It's a nice question. Any other question?
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Dandavat Pranam. प्रभुजी माय क्वेश्चन इज दैट एज वी नो इन भगवद गीता कृष्णा सेज मींस हूएवर डाइज इन मींस इन इन अ सेंस ऑफ मी देन ही विल कम टू मी देन प्रभुजी मींस क्वेश्चन इज दैट इफ एवरीथिंग इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन माइंड इफ मींस इफ वी प्रभुजी अगर एक तरह से मैं ये कहना चाह रहा था कि अगर कृष्णा कहते हैं कि वहां उसमें कुछ डाउट तो नहीं है लेकिन अगर हम उस चेतना में हैं तो प्रभु जी ऐसा तो फिर माइंड हो गया ना सबसे बड़ा फिर हम ऐसा कैसे बोल सकते हैं कि वहां पर भी कुछ ऐसा होगा या फिर नहीं होगा तो जी वो अंडरस्टैंडिंग कैसे लाए कि वो कृष्णा जो कह रहे हैं उसमें डाउट ना हो
इंग्लिश क्लास सो यू आर सेइंग दैट कृष्णा सेज दैट वन हु थिंक्स ऑफ मी एट द एंड ऑफ क्विटिंग एट द एंड ऑफ हिज लाइफ विल कम बैक टू मी
Yes. Right? Yes, Prabhu. And how we can say it's...
What is the question?
And how, Prabhuji means, how we can believe it if someone saying in preaching, there are many people who say if Krishna is saying that, how we can conclude that it that is absolute truth, then mind is greater than Krishna, Prabhu. Then how we can conclude that in a preaching that when Krishna is saying, then that is absolute
mind
truth.
Mind is greater than Krishna. My mind is greater than Krishna?
Yes, means Prabhu, in preaching, I got a question from one person who says that if Krishna is saying...
Okay, so you are saying that person asked you because it depends on the state of mind. That means mind is superior to Krishna.
Yes, yes, Prabhuji. That's why I'm unable to answer.
That is not a... Okay. I understood your question somehow, but that is, see, what is mind? Mind is like an instrument, like spectacles. So spectacles is used to see, right? So mind is also one indriya, one sense of the soul. Like Krishna says, Mama ivancha jiva loke jiva bhuta sanatana manas ashthani indriyani prakriti sthani karshati. So mind is one of the senses. It has been given to us. So Krishna wants that using the mind, we should think of him. So superior is Krishna and I am also superior to mind. Soul is superior to mind. So what to speak of Krishna? Krishna is superior to the soul also. So the point is Krishna wants that using the mind we should think of him. So engaging the mind in thinking. Man mana bhava mad bhakti. So that is the essence of bhakti. That using our mind we think of Krishna. Okay?
Okay, okay, Prabhuji.
Any other questions? Any other question anybody has?
Hare Krishna, anyone has questions, you can unmute and ask.
we have here, I was in Prabhupada's house. We have Karbhajan Prabhu here.
Karbhajan Prabhu. You know, has he got a question?
Hare Krishna. Lavang Lakte Mataji is saying Hare Krishna to you. So you have some comment to make, Prabhu? Please come and.
We are not ready to go to when Krishna is asking us to come back. We are not ready to. But from Acharya, Prabhupada has given the example. When Prabhupada wanted to leave the body, he was ready to leave the body. He was not thinking that it was bad. So please follow Acharya. That whenever Krishna is asking to leave the body, he will be ready.
So he's saying that whenever Krishna calls us, we should not be like that stupid wife of Tukaram ji, who said, "No, I have so many duties." So as devotees also we think, "Oh, I have so many services to do." But Srila Prabhupada didn't say like that. When the time came in 1977, Srila Prabhupada gave up eating. And he didn't go to any hospital. He just lied down in his bed in Prabhupada's house, the house that he saw. And he was ready. He told his disciples that he can pray, "Oh Krishna, if you so desire, let Srila Prabhupada remain with us." He didn't force, "Oh Krishna, please, you must allow me to be here." You know, imagine if Srila Prabhupada would have been here for 5 years or 10 years, so much more preaching could have happened. But no, Srila Prabhupada answered the call of Krishna, that enough, Krishna sent me here to preach. Now Krishna is calling me back, so let me be prepared to go back. So yes, similarly, we see the example of Pandavas. The moment Krishna left the spiritual world, the Pandavas immediately they left. They didn't even take 1 second. Yes, even Parikshit Maharaj, the moment he was cursed, he was ready. He didn't try to counter the curse. So devotees always looking for the opportunity that they can full time, you know, they can completely absorb themselves in thought of Krishna and give up this body. Because that is the final exam, and that is the most important test that we all have to go through, death, the final exam. So, and for that, we should prepare throughout our life, and we should throughout our life chant nicely and do nice Shravan Kirtan, engage ourselves in devotional service, in preaching the message of Bhagavad Gita, and then Krishna arrange somehow that at the time of death we can.
Hello.
Okay, so thank you all very much.
Okay, now we've got two waiting now. We've got Vasu and Iris. Vasu, you were here first. Do you want to ask?
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Why the God has created this world? The reason behind the creation of the world?
Oh, why the Lord has?
Created this world.
Can you repeat your question, please? Why the
Lord
world has created this material world?
Yeah, this is material world.
Okay, the question is, very good question, that why Krishna created this material world? Okay, because there are some souls like us, like me, like those who are staying in this material world, wanted to enjoy separate from the Lord. Therefore, the Lord created this world for us, so that we can try to enjoy in this world. Because see, Krishna doesn't force us to love Him. Krishna has given us free will. So he wants that we should serve him. But some of the souls, they don't want to serve him. They want to enjoy on their own. So then Krishna says, okay, you go and enjoy in this world. Just like Srila Prabhupada gives example, like a father has a son, like he has many sons, but one son is adamant. No, I want to stay away from you. Then father says, okay. Then he gives him some money and says, okay, you go to another city. Just like that. So he wanted to be away from the Lord, wanted to enjoy separate from the Lord. But the father is always hoping for the day when the son will come back home. Similarly, Lord is waiting that when we'll go back home, back to God. Okay? So this world has been made for those people who don't want to serve Lord, who want to enjoy in their own. Okay? Clear, Mataji?
Yes, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna.
Okay, any other question?
Yeah, Vasu, you've been waiting. Vasu is there and
yes, Vasu, please.
Please speak.
Okay. Yeah.
Otherwise, Vaikunth was coming again.
Yeah, Vaikunth, you can ask.
My doubt is clear, Prabhuji.
Okay, Vaikunth already asked the question. Okay, Vasu, yes, you have a question? Yes, please ask.
He's unmuted, but he's not asking.
Okay, no problem. Okay, Mataji.
All right, thank you very much, Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
I think we can end now.
Yes, Prabhu.
Thank you so much, Mataji, and thank you all for attending. Shri Prabhupada ki jai, Shrimad Bhagavad Gita ki jai, Shri Shrutam Maslat ki jai, Nitai Gurpe Manande Hari.